Hello viewers, this is an educational video in which we will explain various types of plumbing fittings used in the water supply system in buildings. This video shall be useful for the students and faculty members of architecture and civil engineering for undergraduate level studies. Through this video, we will study basics of plumbing, water supply system, plumbing pipes and plumbing fittings, flow rate and water supply fixture unit, water supply pipe sizing, and types of valves. Plumbing can be understood everything related to the pipes, fixtures, and other apparatus inside a building for bringing in the water supply and removing the liquid and waterborne wastes. As a process, the plumbing can be defined as the installation of the pipes, fixtures, and other apparatuses. We may often be confused with these two terms, what is fitting and what is fixture, and we will gather the information on next slide. As per National Building Code of India, Part 9, Clause 2.1.54, fittings are defined as coupling, flange, branch, band, tees, elbows, unions, waste with plug, P or S trap with vent, stop ferrule, stop tap, bib tap, pillar tap, globe tap, ball valve, cistern storage tank, baths, water closets, boiler, geyser, pumping with motor and accessories, water meter, hydrant, valves, and any other article used in the connection with water supply, drainage, and sanitation. Whereas the fixture unit is a quantity in terms of which the load producing effect on the plumbing system of different kind of plumbing fixtures is expressed on some arbitrarily chosen scale. For an example, spout of bathtub is considered as a fitting, whereas its fixture unit is considered equivalent to 3, so far as water consumption is concerned by the particular fitting. Now we will understand more about plumbing system. The plumbing system shall include the water supply and distribution pipes, plumbing fittings and traps, soil, waste and vent pipes and anti-siphonage pipes, building drains and building sewers including their respective connections, devices and appurtenances within the property lines of the premises, and water treating or water using equipments. There are so many systems which works within a building. For example, cold water system, hot water system, natural gas system, vent system, and drainage system. However, the scope of our video is limited to water supply system, and water supply system starts as soon as our boundary or of the plot starts, and there may be a water meter installed, there may be a pump installed, there are water pipes, there may be an underground water tank or the overhead water tank, from where there shall be main pipes, main outlet pipes, and there shall be branches which will lead to the user end, which are basically the fixture units installed in the toilets and the kitchens. Also, hot water system starts from the tapping point of cold water system in the toilets or in the kitchen, and it is supplied to the water heater or the geyser, and then it is further supplied to the appropriate fixtures. You may like to refer to the National Building Code of India, Part 9, Plumbing Services, in which you may study terminology associated with water supply, drainage, and sanitation. Also, Indian Standard IS 10446, issued in 1983, glossary of terms relating to water supply and sanitation system is worth recommended for your further studies. So far as the learning of related terminology is concerned, we shall be discussing various types of fittings and valves to be used in water supply system in this video. Water supply system of a building or any premises consists of the water service pipe, the water distribution pipes, and the necessary connecting pipes, fittings, control valves, and all appurtenances in or adjacent to the building which are required in order to make the system work for the building. Water supply pipes may be of the following materials: cast iron, vertically cast or centrifugally, or we call it spun cast. They may be of steel. They may be of reinforced concrete or prestressed concrete, galvanized mild steel tubes, copper, brass, wrought iron, asbestos cement pipes, polyethylene pipes, unplasticized PVC, we call it UPVC, chlorinated PVC, we call it CPVC, or stainless steel. Water supply pipes can be connected using certain fittings like elbow, straight T, reducing T, sanitary T. For sanitary system or the drainage system, we use P-trap or S-trap in the drainage system. There may be a gate valve in water supply system. We know the shower head, we know the lavatory and the taps, we know the bathtubs and shower stalls. This is a fantastic image I could get from the internet resources, and through this image we can understand the water supply system in very simple manner, particularly for domestic buildings. What exactly water supply system comprises? It comprises the supply line coming from the municipality or the underground water tank connected with the pump. So this is the supply line. There is a on-off valve installed here so that flow of water to the tank may be controlled. And this is the outlet from the tank. This is the outlet pipe in which we can have certain branch, and in this image we are viewing multiple taps, but for our residential building we can consider every branch leads to different toilet or the kitchen. So we can see this is a vertical pipe and with the T at the top installed, and the purpose of this pipe is to facilitate release of trapped air, because sometimes air may be trapped somewhere in the pipeline and hence water flow may be obstructed to a particular segment of the water supply system. So if we don't provide such a vertical pipe right at the outlet, so trapped air may not be released and hence we may experience troubles in getting smooth water supply in our fixtures. Now let us pay attention to all the locations which are encircled with red circle. At this circle at the bottom, this is the elbow connecting the pipes. In this circle, there is a union which is used to join the two pipe ends in any pipeline. This is known as the gate valve. This is the elbow, and the fixture which is, or the fitting which is not visible, is the float valve which is inside the tank and is not visible. In this particular circle we can see a tank nipple which is installed at the bottom of the tank at designated location by puncturing the tank, and this provides the outlet, and a further pipe or the T or the elbow may be connected. And this is the pipeline. Again, we can see there is a union connected here. We will discuss the purpose of union in coming slides. Then there is an elbow again. The pipeline is directed to downwards. And this is the branching. There is a T installed. There is an elbow installed. There is a T installed here. There is an elbow installed here. And these all are pipes. In this case, this seems 15 mm pipe only, whereas the supply line seems a bit thicker and it may be of 25 mm in this case. So in this picture, I would like to repeat that there are multiple taps, but for our understanding and learning purposes, we should consider that this is the water tank kept at the top of our, or that the roof of our house, and these branches, they lead to different toilets and the kitchen in our house. This is the tank nipple. This is the external side of the tank. This is the internal side of the tank. And this is fixed while unwinding this plug and putting this side into the tank at the punctured location. And one washer, there are two washers. One washer remains on the external side. Another washer is fixed to the internal side. And these washers of flexible material or the rubber, they help in keeping the joint watertight. This is a good practice to install a ball valve just immediately after the tank nipple, through which we can control the flow of water in the entire pipeline by putting it on or off. This is a small piece of pipe having threads either side on external ends. This is termed as nipple in plumbing terminology. This may be of 3 inch long, 4 inch long, 6 inch long, or maybe 9 inch long. This is T. This is the cross section of this T and this is the external image. If this diameter and this diameter is same, then we call it standard T. Or if this particular diameter is shorter than this particular diameter, then we call it reducing T. For an example, this diameter may be of 25 mm and this diameter may be of 15 mm, then we call it 15-25 reducing T. And the same concept is applicable in elbow also. If both the diameters are same, then we call it standard elbow, or if one side diameter is reduced, we call it reducer elbow. And this is the socket. This is having threads at both the ends in internal side, and this is used to join two pipes in a linear manner. Based on this external profile, hexagonal profile, this fitting is known as hex nipple, having threads either side. This is 45 degree elbow, whereas we had just seen on earlier slide the 90 degree elbow or the standard elbow. This is reducer socket. This is the straight socket or the standard socket, but if one end is reduced diameter, then this is known as reducer socket. And this is male female reducing elbow. If threads are worked out inside, then it is a female end. If threads are worked out outside, then it is a male end. And in this particular fitting, we can see this is the male end, this is the female end, and reducing as well. So it is known as male female reducing elbow. This device is termed as union and is very much used wherever we install the water tank or the pumps. We can see this is the cross section of this fitting. This is the union nut. This is the union nut, and this is union tail piece, and this is union thread piece. We can see there are threads marked here, and by rotating this nut, both these ends can be put few millimeters apart or can be tightened to have a close contact. And this particular device is used when there are two pipes are to be joined and there is very limited gap in between. But main purpose of this device is not only the joining pipes, but this device really helps in order to detach any pump or a water tank if it is to be sent for any repair or maintenance purposes. We can see there is a union provided here, there is a union provided here, and in case this pump is to be replaced or this require any maintenance, so this entire portion can be detached, this pump can be detached by just opening this union and opening this union, and another pump may be installed at the same location. Similarly, in the case of water tanks, the unions help a lot if it is to be cleaned or if it is to be replaced after a certain interval. In this diagram, we can understand that plumber could have installed here the single piece of pipe, but intentionally he has provided unions, and these will really help whenever this pump would require any maintenance. So by simply opening these unions, this entire assembly can be detached from the main system and another standby or new pump can be installed. In any hex nipple, if both the ends are of similar diameter, we call it a standard hex nipple, but hex nipples are also available in reducing profiles where diameter of both the ends is different. And this particular fitting is termed as bush or hex bush. And we can see there are threads in internal face and as well as on external face. And this is used wherever we have an outlet of larger dia, but any tap or fitting of shorter dia is to be mounted in that particular point. So first of all, we will install this bush into that larger dia female end, and then we will mount our fixture or the fitting of reduced dia to this end. And these are also available in reducing formats where diameter at this end and diameter at this end may be different. This is the hex plug and is used to stop or terminate any open end. And this particular fitting is known as stopper or the end cap or the end plug or the plug. So this is also used to terminate or to cover any open ends in the plumbing system when it is under installation. For any architect or civil engineer, it is very important to recognize all these plumbing fittings by their profile or by just viewing them, and also the function of all these fittings. For we will have a recap what we have learned so far. We have discussed the tank socket or the tank nipple, the simple nipple or reducer nipple, the union, ball valve we have seen, and gate valve we will see in coming sections. We have seen socket or the coupling. We have seen pipes, and any pipe which is in the form of a circular or a segment, it is known as band. We have seen reducer or male-female reducer. We have seen elbow or the reducing elbow. We know what exactly male-female elbow is and 45 degree elbow is. We have seen the T and the reducer T. We have not seen Y, but we will see in the coming section perhaps. The cross T or the crossings are also available as plumbing fittings. Hex nipple we have seen. Plug stop plug in the square shape or in hexagonal shape we have seen. We have seen the bush and the hex nut. We will just revise. What do we see in this picture? We see a bush. We see a union. This is a 45 degree elbow. This is an standard elbow. This is a crossing. This is the crossing. This is a standard T. This is male-female reducing elbow. This is a standard socket. This is reducer elbow. This is hex nipple, and this is simply reducer. And all these fittings are available in standard diameters for as their nominal bore or the internal diameter. These are available in 15 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm, 32 mm, 40 mm, 50 mm, 65, 80 and 100 mm nominal bore sizes. This 15 mm is generally known as half inch fitting. 20 mm size is considered as 3/4 inch, and 25 mm size is considered as 1 inch size. All these plumbing fittings are available in three major materials. One is GI fitting, another is UPVC, and third one is CPVC. You may like to download and study further IS code 2065-1983, code of practice for water supply in buildings, and I am sure that you can recognize majority of these fittings except one, which is this one. Can you please name this fitting? Perhaps no, just try to understand what exactly this is. Okay, you understand what exactly this is? This is union with an elbow. So this is union elbow. Hope you are clear by this point of time that how main supply line from the water tank kept at the rooftop has to be obtained, and assuming that this vertical pipe is directly coming from the water tank installed at the rooftop and this is filled with water. Now let us start understanding where we would require which type of fitting. So if we discuss about this junction, so which fitting is required here? Can you just name it out? Okay, a crossing is required, but a standard crossing or the reducer crossing? Obviously the reducer one, because this is of larger diameter and these branches are of a smaller diameter. So if this is 25 millimeter and this is 15 millimeter, so a reducer crossing of 25 and 15 is required at this junction. We require an elbow here, we require a T here, and if we understand, we require a T here, we require an elbow here. So I am sure that with these inputs, now you can understand which type of fitting is required, where, at which junction in water supply system. Just look at this image for few seconds and try to gather some meaningful information or the learnings from this image. Can you learn something out of this image? Okay, what type of pipes are there? What type of fittings are there? But is there any crossing? Is there any overlapping of pipes? There are pipes of different diameters used in this, indicated in this image. These may be the vertical pipelines coming out from the top and leading to the lower floors, whereas these pipelines are branched out to this floor. So there is no overlapping of pipes visible in this image. And this is the wise decision or the skills of the designer, how judiciously you plan the outlets from the water tank and distribute it to your building. It is the task of the designer to conceptualize and work out water supply system and depict it through appropriate diagrams as indicated in this image, so that any potential clashes, challenges or problems can be envisaged before its execution. Water supply drawings are also prepared by architects and civil engineers. We can see these two pipes, they indicate the vertical water supply pipes, and out of these two pipes, branches or tappings are there, and this red line indicates the hot water supply line, this blue line indicates the cold water supply line, and it is the discretion of the designer to design the system so that everything is optimized. This is another drawing indicating the execution or good for construction drawing for water supply system. I hope we could gather basic understanding of water supply system and the fittings are to be used in a water supply system. Now we will understand how pipe sizes are to be calculated in a water supply system. National Building Code of India, in its Part 9, recommends water supply fixture units for different fixtures with minimum pipe sizes. Through this table, we can see that for a bathtub spout, the water supply fixture units are considered 4, whereas the requirement can be fulfilled by 15 millimeter dia pipe. For ablution tap, the water supply fixture unit is considered 1. For cloth washer or the washing machine, it is 4. For dishwasher, it is 1.5. For kitchen sink, it is 2. For shower, it is 2. And minimum pipe size is required 15 millimeter. So the above table is based on Hunter's method, and Hunter's method of estimating load in plumbing systems is based on assigning a fixture unit weightage to the plumbing fixtures and then converting these to equivalent liters per minute requirement. Based on the theory of probability of usage and based on the observation that all fixtures are not used simultaneously. This is the enlarged version of the table from the code. We can see ablution tap is considered one fixture unit and requirement can be fulfilled by 15 millimeter dia pipe. Bathtub supplies by spout is considered unit fixture 3. Shower tall domestic 2 and wash basin for domestic use 1, wash basin for public use 2. Scrub station in hospitals where doctors have to wash their hands before any operation and the tap is to be closed by the elbow only, the water supply requirement or fixture unit load is considered 3. Drinking water fountains are considered half of the water supply fixture unit. Water closet with flush or magic eye operated wall, the load is considered equivalent to 8 water supply fixture unit. And nowadays the flush valve or the magic eye operated valves are available in which water requirement is not fulfilled by the 15 millimeter dia pipes, but we need a vertical stack of minimum 25 and 32 millimeter for some of the manufacturers. The flow rate and flush volumes of different fixtures or the fittings are given in table 4.7.3.3 in National Building Code of India, where water closets are considered that they are flushed at the rate of 6 liter per flush. Urinals require 3.8 liter per flush, and sink or faucets, they need 8 liters per minute. Bidet or handheld spray devices, they need 8 liters per minute. Shower heads require 10 liters per minute of water flow. However, whenever we are designing green buildings and we have to apply for any rating for our green buildings, so they recommended that the flow rate of the fittings or fixtures installed in our toilets, particularly in wash basin, should not be so high, and it should be limited to 2.4, 2.5 liters per minute. If we consider a water pressure of 4.2 kg per centimeter square at the user end, then water flow rate out of 15 millimeter dia pipe is 24 liters per minute. And for 20 millimeter dia pipe, it would be 48 liters per minute. For 25 mm dia pipe, flow rate would be 96 liter per minute at a water pressure head of 4.2 kg per centimeter square. At the same pressure, flow rate out of 32 millimeter dia water supply pipe would be 180 liters per minute, and flow rate would be 240 liters per minute for 40 millimeter dia pipe. So this rule of thumb or the basic information really helps us in determining pipe sizes in a water supply system. And how will it help us? For an example, if we have started the outlet of 40 millimeter from the main water tank, then we know that water pressure would be, or the flow rate would be, 240 liters water per minute, or 240 liters water can be discharged in 1 minute. So how many branches of 32 mm can be connected to this 40 mm dia pipe? Obviously not more than 2. And how many branches of 25 millimeter can be connected to this 40 millimeter dia pipe outlet? So maybe 3, because the flow rate of water has to be equal, almost equal. And now we can very well understand that if we have installed a tank nipple of 40 millimeter dia at the bottom of the tank, and this is the ball valve of 40 millimeter dia. So 40 millimeter dia pipe would be taken out, and it can be branched out either in two pipes of 32 millimeter dia, or it can be branched out in three pipes of 25 mm dia. And further, based on the flow rate of water at a certain specific pressure, this 25 millimeter dia pipe can be further branched out in four pipes of 15 millimeter dia. And out of this each pipe of 15 millimeter dia, at least toilet fixtures in a single toilet can be catered. We can connect one tap for the wash basin. We can connect one angle wall for the cistern supply of WC, and we can connect two other water taps for bathing purposes. Through this diagram, we will try to understand that water pressure in any water supply system or in a particular pipe would not be the similar at both the ends, the starting point or the user end point. And it depends on the length of pipe, the number of fittings used, maybe the elbows or the T's or the bends in the pipe, and there will be certain pressure drop at the user end, and water pressure at the user end would not be similar as it was at the starting point. In National Building Code of India, Part 9, nomogram of Hazen and Williams is given, and it is applicable to all pipe sizes 15, 20, 25, 32, 40, 50, 65, 80, and 100 millimeter nominal bore. And pipe sizing process can be suggested as that we have to determine the layout of each fixture, then we have to assume a pipe diameter, then we have to determine the flow rate, we have to determine the effective pipe length, we have to calculate the permissible loss of head at the user end, then we have to determine the pipe diameter, and then we have to repeat our calculations, or some iterations may be required in order to achieve an optimized solution. This is the nomogram of Hazen and Williams illustrated in National Building Code of India, and it has four vertical columns. And on these columns, in one of the column, it indicates head loss in meters per meter run. And on second column, it indicates the velocity of water in the pipeline meter per second. In a water supply system, we are not really concerned about the velocity because it's really difficult to measure the velocity inside the pipeline for all the buildings. So we generally don't use this column, and we depend on 1, 2 and this 3 column. In third column, flow rate of water through the pipe in liters per second is indicated. And in the fourth column, external diameter and internal diameter of the pipe is indicated. So how do we calculate the pipe sizing, or how do we derive our estimates for the pipe sizing out of this nomogram? So we have to draw a straight line. We have to draw a straight line. For an example, if we consider this red line, so we are talking about internal diameter 20 millimeter, and it cuts here. It means flow rate of water would be 1 liter per second, and the head loss in meters per meter run would be 0.45 meters per meter run. And if we consider the case of this blue line, then for internal nominal bore of 25 millimeter, the flow rate would be the similar, and the head loss would be 0.18 or 0.16 meters per meter run. So we can draw any line. We can draw a line starting from this point to this point, and it will give us relative figures. We can draw a line starting from this point to this point, and we will get the relative figures. So all the calculations are estimated only, and these are not very precise calculations, because even we experience in structural design that after huge calculations we determine that 4.2 bars of 16 millimeter diameter are to be put in the beam. So we have no other option but we have to place 5 bars of 16 millimeter diameter. So in the similar way, these calculations are also estimates only and not very precise in nature. We had discussed the branching pattern also. So based on our estimates and some calculations out of this nomogram of Hazen and William, it is the discretion of designer, and a designer may consider branching of 332 mm dia pipes out of a 40 mm dia pipe, depending on the use and type of fixtures are to be installed further in the branches. And though recommended figure is 325 mm dia pipe coming out as a branch out of a 40 mm diameter main supply pipe, however, it is the discretion of designer whether to provide 3 pipes or may consider providing 4 branches out of 40 mm dia pipe. I hope that each one of you have got sufficient inputs on water supply system and pipe sizing. Though we have discussed at very basic level, however, I am sure that you can apply the information delivered so far in order to work out the water supply system for a residential unit. Apart from these plumbing fittings, certain valves and other devices are also to be used in water supply system. And these devices are float valve, gate valve, or we also call Swiss valve, ball valve, globe valve, check valve, butterfly valve, and diaphragm valve. This is float valve, and this is a ball in which air is filled, and this is the inlet point of water. When the ball is in down position, so water is allowed to flow into the tank, and as soon as the level of the water raises in the tank, so this ball also floats in the upward direction, and it puts a pressure to the inlet point, and the moment water reaches a particular level, so then outlet of flow of water is stopped at this inlet point. This is the general arrangement diagram of a water tank in which there is a water supply pipe, inlet pipe, and float valve is installed at this particular point, and this is the outlet of the from the water tank. This diagram indicates a ball valve. This spherical part of this fitting is known as ball, and hence it is termed as ball valve. There is a hole across this spherical part. When the hole is aligned in the direction of the water flow, then the ball valve is in on position, and just by turning the quarter radius, this hole can be turned to the opposite direction, and water flow in this particular pipe can be stopped. So we can see if the hole is in perpendicular direction to the water flow, the water is stopped. And when the ball, when this hole is in alignment of the water flow or the pipe, then water can flow through the hole, and valve is in on position. This is the configuration of a gate valve. The ball valve is very handy and very easy to use, because by just turning a quarter radius, we can put the water supply to on or off. However, in the case of a gate valve or the Swiss valve, this is the configuration, internal configuration of the valve, and these are the discs which blocks the path of water if these are in this at this position. However, by turning it multiple times, the disc can be moved up or down, and water supply can be restored or can be put off through this valve. So this is a sturdy valve. Ball valve usually don't have so much of long life, and they start creating problems. However, this gate valve, the life can be considered very good. The only disadvantage is that we have to turn it multiple times in order to keep the water supply on or off. This is globe valve, and we can see there is a horizontal disk provided in this ball, in this globe ball, whereas in the case of gate valve, the disk was kept in a vertical position. So we can see that if the this horizontal disk is in this stage, so there is no water supply and water supply can be stopped. But after turning multiple times this handle, this horizontal disk can be moved up and the water flow can be ensured into the water supply pipeline. The difference of functioning in gate valve and globe valve is that in gate valve, water pressure has no role to play and the water pressure at the inlet side and the outlet side would be the same. However, through this globe valve, if we are having water pressure higher at one side, so it reduces the water pressure at the other end. In this image, we can see the internal configuration of a globe valve in greater details. This is the configuration of a check valve. A check valve is a device which allows the flow of liquid in a certain direction only. And the moment liquid starts to flow in the reverse direction, so the device does not allow the flow of water into the reverse direction. So if we have installed this valve in any line, so we can ensure that liquid or water can flow in one direction only and there are no chances of backflow from the reverse direction. Can you now please identify which valve is this? Which valve is this one and which valve is this one? I hope it would not be difficult for you to identify now. This is this valve is having a vertical disk, so this is the gate valve. This is having a horizontal disk, so this is globe valve, and this is having a ball inside with a hole across, so this is the ball valve. This is the configuration of a butterfly valve. This is also used to control the flow of water in water supply pipelines. However, the difference in ball valve and butterfly valve is, ball valve is suitable for small dia pipes up to 40 mm or 60 mm, whereas butterfly valve can work very well in larger dia pipe water supply pipelines. So this is the disc, this is the horizontal, this is one of the disc, and by just turning a quarter radius, the disc can be put in this direction or can be ensured in the reverse direction. So in this, if the disc is in this direction, then the supply line is closed, and if the disc is in this direction, mean this is the open supply line. These images illustrates the configuration and the functioning of a diaphragm valve. We can see in this image, this black portion, this is the diaphragm made of inert but flexible material. These diaphragm valves are of two types. One is wear type, in which there is a hump or the niche or the mount here, and in this straightway type, this is the flat, the surface is flat, and this flexible diaphragm has to touch the bottom if we wish to stop the water flow, whereas in that case it doesn't go so down, but it has to touch this tip, so in order to prevent the flow of liquid in the pipeline. This diaphragm valve is used in food processing industries or in pharmaceutical industries, where we wish that our water or the liquid should get no contamination from the devices or the fittings installed in the pipelines. I am sure that you can recognize now all the fittings shown in this image. This is the wall flange, this is the nipple, this is T, this is nipple, this is end cap. And this is again maybe the hex nipple, this is reducer T, this is nipple, this is T, standard T, nipple, a reducer, a hex nipple or the pipe. Then this is flange. So if you have learned and if you have understood all these fittings, so now start playing with it. These fittings are not only used in water supply system, but if you are creative enough, so you can just prepare furniture items or some decorative items at your home using these fittings. If you understand the function of all the plumbing fittings which we have discussed, so you may play with it not only in order to work out a water supply system, but also you can create furniture for your house. And we can see the designer has applied the mind and has created very beautiful shelf for the domestic use. If we give you a set of fittings and we ask you to apply your mind and work out something creative, so I'm sure that each one of you can be innovative and can create so many artifacts out of these fittings. And these are some of the examples how people have created artifacts using these plumbing fittings for their house. We really enjoy learning when we understand all the basics and fundamentals of any field, and then we start playing with it in an innovative manner. So please understand all the basics, study well, and innovate further. Thank you so much.